Hello and welcome to another Japanese building tutorial. We are in 1.16.1 and I thought I would use some new blocks for a new Torii Gate design. Much bigger than the other tutorial that I have. If you want to see that, go and check the playlist out because there are lots of Japanese designs there. I got a picture off Google, as usual, for inspiration, and it was actually a Torii Gate in water like this, so that is why I have done it like this. Unfortunately, I have not got Lightmatica at the minute, so I can't give you the specifics of how many materials that you need, but I am using the new warped planks for the roof, or you could use prismarine, but these may be more readily available. I'm gonna start with the main pillars here, which are 3x3. So these are 3x3, and then we've got the red sandstone around, and then the smooth red sandstone. We're going to put four layers of that. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. If you're in survival, remember, put a torch in there so you don't get anything spawning in there. The walls come off here, leave a gap of 2 and here, and I believe there are 3 in between. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and then it's just a single pillar, exactly the same as that. So one black stone, polished black stone, sandstone, and then 4 of the smooth sandstone, and then we're going to put just one wall on the back of there. So again, whoops, come out 3, polished black stone, red sandstone, 1, 2, 3, 4, then the sandstone like that, and then on the top of here we have smooth red sandstone stone stairs, which is easy enough for me to say. Gonna go round like that and then take the smooth red sandstone. You can put a marker block in there. We're gonna go up 5, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then for the pillars here, we need to go up one more with the red sandstone, then put a polished black stone on, and then round that we're going to put the polished black stone stairs, just like that, and then cap it off with a pressure plate. So the reason why I've used the black polished on the top there is because you can actually see it through there. So it just gives a tiny little bit of definition on there. Once you have that in place, we're going to do the second tower or support. 9 in between, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So again, just like that one, it's a square of 9 with a polished black stone. 1, 2, 3, 4. There's all the way around the top of here. Bring the walls 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Polished black stone, sandstone, smooth red sandstone, and there, and again on this side, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Ooh. Oh, in fact, we could have done one more on there, one more on there. polished blackstone on the top. Stairs just all the way around. Five, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There we have two identical side supports there. And we've got a gap of 2 here, and then we're going to go 3 walls up there, coming out 2 on this side. So leave 2, and that's 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, and come out 2 here. And then down the middle, it is just a wall coming off this bottom one. Whoop. All the way along. Then on top of this pillar, we're going to put a wall, and we're going to come out again 3 from that, so it's in line with this one, and then it's just going to come all the way across. So then at the end, it's 1, 2, 3. Then on this top block here, I'm going to put upside down stairs there, and then come round, upside down stairs, so that then they I know they won't attach to that, but they curve round like that, and again on this side, and then the same on the other side. So one in the middle, come round so it curves round like that, and that's the same for both of the supports. Then exactly the same on the top, but just the stairs are the right way up on this one instead of being upside down. There we've got the two supports. Then in the middle, following this column up, we're going to put another smooth sandstone. And we're just going to run that all the way along the top of the wall. Oh, I'm stuck on something. And then on top of that, we're going to put one which hangs over. Then we're going to just run the smooth red sandstone all the way along, so that then it hangs over one. Put the wall under there, and the same on the other side. A wall on the end as well, like so. Now we're going to get the roof in place. So on the top one here, you're going to miss the first one, and then you're going to put upside down smooth sandstone stairs, and we've got 6. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then the same on the other side, so miss 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Get your warped stairs, and in front of the last one here, I'm going to place them the right way up like that, and on there, and then you're going to get the slabs and just run those all the way through here. Then next to the top of this one, you're going to go slab and a slab on top of that, and then 1, 2, 3, 4 and stairs. So that's slab, slab on top, 1, 2, 3, 4 stairs. Then next to this one on the top, it's slab, slab on top, and then 1 to the side. So again, one on the top, the side, 1 to the top, and 1 to the side. Then in this gap here, we've got slabs running all the way along. Then behind this stair here, we're going to run stairs all the way along on top of those. Then next to this one, again, it's a slab running all the way along to behind the stairs. So that's slabs all the way along. A slab on the corner there, and then stairs up to here. So that's slab on the corner and then stairs up to here. And then behind this stair, got a full plank running along there and then an upside down stair on the end. So that's one, two, three, and an upside down stair on the end. Then on top of this, we're going to put the slabs on either end and a stair on there. So that's stairs in the middle there and a slab on either end. So that takes us to the middle bit here. You just need to replicate that on the other side. That's just that side replicated over there. You may find it easier to do each layer and then do it on the other side as well. But whatever's easiest for you. Then that brings us to the final little bit to fill in the middle. In the middle of these stairs here, I'm just going to run planks, or you could use slabs in there. Then on either side of here, it's a stair, and then planks, and again a stair and planks in there, and then a stair facing this way. Planks. Then on the side of this plank on the end, you do one on the top, one on top of that, and then stick it out like that for the little curve on the end. And then the warped fences go one either side on here with a gate in the middle, one at each end of this one with two gates, and then it's two fences, and then we'll go gate, fence, gate, fence, gate, fence, fence. And then carry that on for this side. Then we just need to fill in the little bit at the end here. So we need to go on top of that red sandstone and bring that out. We're going to take that slab out actually. Pop that in there, add a slab into there so that there's not a gap. So add a slab on there, take that one out, pop that one in there. Need a wall on the end of there, and then we need just one last sandstone piece on there. Again, sandstone bit coming out here. Take that one out, pop a slab in there, and pop this one on. Roofs are always, whoops, trial and error here. And I obviously forgot the ins and outs of what this is like. So we got there in the end. Just a little bit of tweaking there. Then the last detail to do is this kind of decoration in the middle where you will need some gold, the black stone. So we need to find the center of here. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. So that's one, two, three, four. It's going to be the fifth one. Oh, I didn't put the pressure plate on top of these. My apologies. So we're going to go a polished black stone block in the middle there, with a gold block on top, and then put a placeholder block there and an upside down stair there. And then while your placeholder block is still there, come over to the other side and pop these ones on. We're going to take those out. Then it's a polished black stone on the top there with a gold in between. Again, polished black stone with gold in between. And another polished black stone with gold in between on there, upside down stair, and then the slabs just run across, and then one in the middle there to finish it. Upside down stair, run across and one in the middle there, and your Torii Gate is finished. Yay! It took a lot of backwards and forwardsing to replicate that because the roof is slightly complicated, hence the little fiddles that I had to do on the side there, but hopefully you followed that fine, and I will be making this available as a world download so that you can actually come in and see how it has been made. I think that's a really impressive Torii Gate. I think it would make your base or world look really splendid if you had this in it, especially if it was on a water-based world. If you've enjoyed the video, please leave a like and consider subscribing. Always love to hear your comments. If you haven't checked out the other videos in the Japanese playlist, please look at the card at the end, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!